This photo shows the location of the heater control valve, red arrow. It is located at the center of the firewall below the wiper assembly. To access it, remove the wiper assembly. Please see the link at the end of this video for further assistance with wiper assembly replacing. With the wiper assembly removed, you will have to fold the foam shield out of the way, as indicated by the red arrow. Start by folding up the foam shield and placing it under the tab on the cowl, yellow arrow. That will hold it in place. The heater valve is now exposed, red arrow. Remove the upper engine cover. Please see the link at the end of this video for further assistance. Working on the engine side of the firewall, using a flathead screwdriver, lever up the wire lock, red arrow, until it stops. Then pull the heater hose input, yellow arrow, straight out to remove it. Next, remove the upper heater hose clamp, indicated by the red arrow. Use a pair of hose clamp pliers. Slide the clamp with the hose away from the heater control valve to remove it. This style of clamp requires special pliers. Standard pliers won't work. Working on the side and top of the heater control valve, using a flathead screwdriver, lever up the wire locks, red arrows, until they stop. Then pull the rubber grommet out of the firewall. Detach it from the engine side, red arrow, then feed it through the wiper side of the firewall, yellow arrow. Pull the heater valve, yellow arrow, out of the heater core connections towards the engine. If it feels stuck, double check both wire clips are released. They usually come out with a little bit of effort. Once out, flip the valve over, then press the release tab, red arrow, and disconnect the electrical connector by pulling it straight off. Remove the heater valve from the vehicle. This photo shows the valve removed. To install the new valve, reverse the removal steps. Be sure that the wire clips are engaged. Listen for an audible click. Fill and bleed the cooling system. Once complete, double-check all the hoses' connections and check the engine for coolant leaks. Thanks for watching. Click here to view the original article, along with hundreds of other DIY content for your car.